Parent, parent, vice president, or anyone, members of the House Committee on Family and Veterans Committee. My name is Jaime Miracle, and I'm the Deputy Director of NARAL Pro-Choice Ohio. And I am here today to speak in opposition to Council 135 on behalf of more than 20,000 activists and members in Ohio. During sponsored testimony on this legislation, Representative Lafayette said that this bill was not about abortion. I respect the convictions of the sponsor of this bill, but must unequivocally disagree. If this bill is not about abortion, why is its sole purpose banning abortion services to a specific group of women in our state? This bill is just like the other two abortion bans assigned to this committee, an unconstitutional attempt to limit access to a healthcare procedure. This time, instead of banning abortion at 6 weeks or at 20 weeks, this committee is hearing a bill that will ban abortion based on certain medical diagnoses. This bill is not about helping individuals live with disability or the families that love and support them. It is about banning access to abortion care. When a woman and her family face a complicated medical diagnosis during pregnancy, there are a million things that go through their head. Some of the questions she will try to answer include, can I raise a child with disabilities? Would I have access to health care? Are there services for people with disabilities in my community? Can I take the time off work that I need to take care of my child? Do I have maternity leave so my child and I can figure out this complicated diagnosis? Do I have access to specialists to help this child develop and medical professionals to treat possible medical complications? Does my school system have adequate programs in place to educate my child so they can grow to their full potential? Do I have the support system I need to navigate this new world? If this bill really was about helping people facing complicated medical diagnoses during pregnancy, these are the issues this bill would address. Putting the government between a woman and her doctor when making a decision to continue a pregnancy is not how we support families raising children with developmental disabilities. Telling women that the government knows what's best for her and her family is not what this committee and this legislature should be prioritizing. In fact, as we debate this bill, the budget passed by this Ohio House slashes funding for programs to serve people with developmental disabilities. The House passed budget even significantly cuts Medicaid funding for this population. County developmental disability boards have been significantly impacted by the loss of tangible personal property tax reimbursement from the state. And the loss of this money means that these boards lose federal funding opportunities as well. Less money means less services in these communities. Funding for special education programs also falls short of what is needed in the state. According to the Ohio Coalition for the Education of Children with Disabilities, special education funding fell short by $110 million last year. Advocates currently are suing the state of Ohio because the underfunding of our school systems in general has left districts without sufficient resources to provide a proper level of education for special needs students in their districts. Will this woman facing this decision have access to maternity leave or paid sick leave to help her bond with her child and help her continue to earn her wage if she has to take time off to help take care of her child? Looking at the statistics, probably not. In the U.S., only 13% of workers have paid family leave. And when you break that down by wage, only 4% of low-wage workers have paid family leave. Only 59% of workers even have access to unpaid family leave. And most of them cannot afford to take it, even when they have access to it. In Ohio, only 45.9% of workers, in Ohio, 45.9% of workers have no access to paid time off, paid sick leave, when they are a family member or sick, forcing that person to decide between getting paid or taking care of a sick girlfriend. I have sat with a close friend as she had to deal with a complicated medical diagnosis during a very much wanted pregnancy, trying to answer the what if questions, trying to navigate not only what was best for her family, but also balancing that with what was best for her physical and mental health. With this bill, we turn doctors into inquisitors. How do we define knowingly in the banning of this procedure? How will the doctor have to prove that they did not know the reason for the woman terminating her pregnancy? With my friend, I do not think we would have been able to navigate that complicated system and very emotional time if we did not trust your medical providers to be giving her complete information about her situation. When she did make the decision that was right for her and her family, I shudder to think what they'll be able to be doing exactly that. Time and hands of doctors who want to provide the medical care that their patients have chosen as the right care for them. Abortion is a deeply personal and often complex decision for a woman. You can't make that decision for someone else. Ultimately, decisions about whether to choose abortion, adoption, or raise a child must be left to a woman, her family, her faith, with the counsel of her doctor and her health care provider. Thank you so much.